Vsauce! I'm Jake, and in the video game Watch Dogs, you can pretty much hack any piece of technology, from people's phones to ATMs to security cameras or even cars, all from a computer or a cell phone. But how realistic is that compared to our own world? Is Watch Dogs possible? Security cameras are supposed to be there to protect us. They can only be seen by people with specific access. However, using certain Google search terms, you can find hundreds of unsecure camera feeds, allowing you to see things that normally you shouldn't. These are just a few that I was able to find, and in some cases, I could control the camera's features and its movements. So the next time you're in a department store and you see a camera following you around, well, it might be somebody in the back, or it might be someone hundreds of miles away.
Spooky.
But if there are no cameras around, then there's no way for you to be visually tracked or followed. You could slip into the crowd. Except for the fact that at pretty much all times, you have a microphone, a camera, a list of everyone you know, a log of your most sensitive data, and it's all Wi-Fi enabled, with the added bonus of having GPS and a cell network. Your phone contains a lot of data, so much so that it tends to leak information. When you're not connected to a Wi-Fi network, this little guy sends out a list of known networks looking for something to connect to. And once it connects to what it thinks is a known wireless network, the background apps start to transmit a lot of data. Security researcher Brendan O'Connor created a device called F-bomb that plugs into an outlet and acts as a passive network. Your phone connects to it, and immediately the device is able to collect information that your phone is freely giving out. By plugging F-bombs into multiple places, Brendan created a web that was able to track people's locations and what they were doing. Using himself as a test subject, he found that his weather app would give out his exact longitude and latitude, and his newsreader would transmit his full name and email address. Other researchers have used drones to fly wireless networks above public places like parks in order to collect data. And once your device connects to one of these networks, you might use your web browser thinking you're logging into your banking account, when really a hacker is just displaying an identical page, except that your username and password goes to their machine. Or if you're a country's government, there is a product you can purchase to infect a target's phone, enabling you to track their location, listen in on their microphone, or activate their camera to take photos. As devices become more connected, we move closer to the Internet of Things. It is said that the first version of the internet was about data being created by people, and the next version will be data created by things. There are wireless washers and dryers, refrigerators, and bathroom scales. But then there are things that could be deadly, like sniper rifles that are controlled wirelessly, or even pacemakers. There are over 3 million pacemakers and 1.7 million ICDs inside people's chests. And in 2006, they started becoming wireless. In 2013, researcher Barnaby Jack found a way to hack them. From 50 feet away, he could either have them shut down entirely, or he could have it send a high voltage shock of 830 volts directly to the heart. Barnaby was also able to hack insulin pumps, and as long as you were within a 300-foot radius, he could have the pump inject all of the insulin, about 45 days worth, in one go, a potentially fatal amount. He was also responsible for a hack that we've all probably dreamed of, where he jackpotted multiple ATMs, forcing the machines to spit out money. However, a week before he was going to safely demonstrate his research on pacemakers and ICDs, he was found dead from a drug overdose. Hacking pacemakers and insulin pumps is scary, but it only affects the people who have those devices implanted in them, so it doesn't really disrupt a large portion of the population the way hacking something like a car can. By attaching something like this small iPhone-sized device to a few wires under the car, you get complete access to the vehicle wirelessly. Researchers have shown just what is possible, like disabling the brakes, turning the steering wheel in any direction, killing the engine, or changing the dash's display to show you have a full tank of gas when you don't. All of this can be done from miles away. There is a great Motherboard documentary that shows just what is possible once you access a car's CAN bus. The vehicle can even be programmed so that when you hit a certain speed, different parts of the car stop functioning, leaving you trapped. Let's get out of the car. So maybe we should start using older technology, like this GirlTech Instant Messenger. It looks pretty secure, and it operates on the same frequency range as the radios used by most law enforcement agencies. And with a little firmware hack, the GirlTech can jam all of their radio communications, Here, I'll trade you. Thank you very much. This cell phone has an accelerometer. Most cell phones have an accelerometer, and it measures the force of acceleration and also the angle and direction the phone is being held in. It's the reason why the screen flips depending on the phone's orientation. A team at Georgia Tech came up with a technique where they would place a phone on a table next to a computer keyboard. When someone would start typing on the keyboard, the phone's accelerometer would pick up the vibrations through the table and, with a little bit of software, was able to accurately predict what the person was typing. Now, all this kind of hacking takes a lot of time and a lot of skill, but there is a way that's as easy as 2 + 2 = 5. Social engineering. It's a technique where you manipulate people to do things or give you information they ordinarily wouldn't. Thank you. Kevin Mitnick, one of the most wanted computer hackers in the world before his arrest, was able to hack into telephone systems and computer networks, not only because of his amazing skills with a computer, but his amazing skills of talking on the phone. By saying enough information to sound convincing, he could pretty much get any sensitive data he wanted. In his book, Ghosts in the Wires, he mentions how if you pretend like you have the information already and give it wrong, people will generally correct you. Let's go inside. So, for example, when I said 2 + 2 = 5, you probably thought that I was wrong. You might have even left a comment saying that I was wrong and that the correct answer is 2 + 2 = 4. If so, then you've been hacked. By knowingly giving you the wrong answer, you willingly gave me the correct one. So phones, cars, ATMs, security cameras, and even pacemakers can all be hacked, just not as easily or seamlessly as in watchdogs. But still, the easiest system to hack is you. And as always, thanks for watching.
Take a mission to block out.